Cybersecurity at the Department of Homeland Security says a foreign government could launch a cyber attack by targeting home or office networks in the United States.
If somebody is sitting on those routers or those switches, they have full access to all of that data. They can potentially manipulate that.
Cyber war defense on the next morning edition.
Morning edition, weekdays from 4 until 9 on 88.5 KNKX. Now back to Sound Effect on 88.5 KNKX.
You're listening to Sound Effect. I'm Gabriel Spitzer, and our theme today is barflies. Bars can be many things to many people, a den of iniquity, a dating market, or in the case of Seattle writer Hannah Brooks Olson, an office, a finishing school, and a daycare facility. She shares this essay.
I always joke that dark, grimy bars are where I'm most at home, because that's where I feel so
comfortable. Talking to people. Most of my life, I've supported myself through talking. Talking my way into AP classes, and talking myself out of a trespassing charge when I pretended to be a caterer in order to eat leftovers after a banquet. Talking to people, the kind of talking that I learned in bars and from bar flies, requires a quick wit, sure, but it's also about what you do when you're not speaking. It is impossible to be a good talker without being a good listener. My mom calls it the gift of gab, but I think it's more like the skill of sticking. I mean it when I say I'm a fucking boss, and that I like it. When I was 2 and 3 years old, my grandfather, a salty old man with a majestic mustache, gray, wiry, combed and waxed to be a kind of grin on a special occasion, used to take me to the bar with him when he was babysitting. I'd hop in his truck, always a Ford, and nothing else. And ultimately, we'd make it to our final destination, a tiny tavern in Eugene, Oregon. A dim and peanut-smelling place.
Folding mirror.
He'd sit me on the bar.
Ultrasonic mirror.